Dear friend, you are welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to practically show how to do continuity test on a three-phase motor. All right, so as you can see in this video, in every three-phase motor, six wires are brought out to the terminal block for connection. And these six wires help to connect the motor in either star or delta configurations and also to supply. So each two of these wires are connected to the start and the finish of a particular winding in the motor. In the three-phase motor, there are three windings, one, two, three windings. And each of the windings has a starting point and a finishing point. And for this three-phase motor to work, each winding must be supplied with 400 volts to generate or to create a magnetic field. And this can only be achieved if all the windings are continuous without any break. And so if a three-phase motor is switched on and it is not rotating, this could mean that there is a break in one of the three windings. And this fault can be checked or can be detected by the use of a continuity tester or a multimeter. And so if the motor is not working and you want to check if there is a break in any of the windings, then you use a continuity tester or a multimeter to check the continuity of all the windings. All right, so in this video, I am going to use a multimeter to do the continuity test. Okay. The continuity test means that the beginning and the end of each winding should be continuous without any break. Okay, so I have set the meter in a way that if there is continuity between the beginning and the end or the start and finish of a winding, the meter will sound. And so that sound will mean that there is no break in that particular winding. Or it should read very low resistance. Very low resistance is 00. Okay. And so by the color code that is used for these wires, I can easily identify the beginning and the end of a particular winding. You can see yellow, white, and blue. And then at the down, you see white, blue, and yellow. What it simply means is that if this is the beginning of a particular winding, that winding ends here. If this is the beginning of a particular winding, this particular winding ends here. And if this white is the end of a particular winding, then it means it started from here. So simply to check the continuity of the motor windings, what I'm going to do is that first, I'm going to test between this and then this. To test the continuity of this winding, I'll use one of the meter leads here, and then I'll use the other here. Okay. All right, so I have set the multimeter in such a way that if the winding is continuous, it should create a sound, or it should sound. So the sound that is coming out clearly tells that this winding is continuous. There is no break in it. Then I move to the next one. So that is the first winding. The first winding, it's continuous. There is no problem. So I move to the next one, color white. And then I look for the other white at the down. And then that is also continuous. The last one, blue, and then blue. All right, so it means all the windings of this motor are continuous. And so I don't have any problem with the windings. There are other faults that cannot be detected by the multimeter, such as insulation problems. There could also be what we call insulation wear out on the windings. And if insulation problem is left unchecked for a long time, the motor can bend. If you want to check the insulation resistance of the windings, then you have to use an insulation resistance tester, what people normally refer to as a mega tester. So the mega tester will help you to know how strong the insulation on the windings are so that there would not be any short circuits as you continue using the motor. And I already have a video on how to do insulation resistance tests on the motor windings. And so I have shared the link to that video in the description of this very video. So friends, if you have learned something new from this video, kindly like and share with others. And don't forget to subscribe if you have not yet done that. Thank you very much for watching this video.